international law and human rights, jurisprudence, legal education, legal research, public law, media law, comparative law, family law, community legal services, global justice, biodiversity and biotechnology, law and business and human rights. So very rich experience, very rich academic qualifications to her credit. I request Guru Madam to have a very short presentation.
Thank you, Dr. Naurangi, the chair, and honorable chief guest and other members of the panel and the other chairpersons. It's a pleasure to just to share a couple of points. Most of the facets of medical negligence have been captured by the esteemed speakers, whether it is the legal angle or the judging angle or the consumer point of view. Just two observations before it is thrown open to the audience. The critical aspects which were supposed to be captured are already done by our esteemed chief guest, so there isn't much to contribute from my side. I would just make a couple of points. One is the trend in the National Consumer Forum and the way the Supreme Court has been treating appeals from the National Consumer Forum. Second is the fear in the minds of the doctors, or rather phobic approach which the doctors are taking, which as the judge from Nagpur assured, Justice Bangale assured, that there is no need for such phobia because there is no straitjacket approach. Each case's outcome varies on the facts and circumstances of the case. And as it was told, if there is absolute care taken, now this is where the medical negligence case is different from traffic accident or railroad accident. Probably the compensation should be higher than that because there is a higher duty of care which is expected because of the trust and the bona fide of the relationship. Now, with that little observation, I would request the chairpersons to ask questions. I would call upon Dr. Kani to ask a question to the panel, please.
Dr. Nagpal, I have a question for you that many Supreme Court decisions state that mistakes, error of judgments, misadventures are not negligence. But in reality, it seems as if even the slightest errors have been taken as negligence. How are the courts deciding this?
I'll take the example of Kunal Saha judgment, which was discussed. Justice Shah is here. You have to realize the top National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission is the top consumer court in the country. What happened when Dr. Kunal Saha first approached National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission? The National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission, sir was part of that, said that there is no negligence. This is the top consumer court saying there is no negligence. Problem arose because a judicial magistrate first class had given a judgment that there is criminal negligence. Actually, the bar for criminal negligence should be higher than the bar for consumer negligence. And here the top consumer court was saying no negligence, but the criminal court of judicial magistrate first class had awarded 3 months simple imprisonment. So the whole matter was taken to the Supreme Court. And in light of this, that one court had ordered criminal negligence and the top consumer court was saying no, there is no negligence, the Supreme Court decided, okay, no criminal negligence, but there seems to be a case for civil negligence and referred the case back to National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission. So now, under the circumstances, we are talking of the same incidents. We are not talking of two different incidents. Nothing in between changed in the data. So effectively, the problem is with us, it is not the crime. It is the complainant who decides what penalty I am to be awarded. It is the complainant whose forceful pursuit of the case basically is on that is dependent what compensation I am awarded. Because the crime remains the same. And in similar cases, you find so much variation in the amount of compensations and even in compensation or no compensation being awarded.
Yeah, but between the J.J. Merchant case and D'Souza case, or after the D'Souza case and before the 2010 case, which Justice Shah decided, there was a kind of gap, and the degree of negligence in terms of the consumer court not being, I mean, solely dependent on expert evidence was something that was present at that time as well, isn't it? And the Kunal Shah case was the one which gave a kind of what we call as exemplary damages. This, in a way, was in terms of even the right to life, which is connected constitutionally. So isn't there a larger implication for medical profession from that one?
Madam, we are a little confused about this. Because initially, the National Commission Service here has declared that this was no negligence. And the same thing can be turned into a negligence case. And then the convention initially awarded on the request that it was reprimanded to National Forum, they gave something like 1.25 crores. And then it has been hiked to 11 crores. So if the judiciary itself has changed its own decisions, how a doctor with a fraction of a second has to make a decision? A small mistake is penalized to this extent.
Actually, when it came to the National Commission, it was not really dismissed, they did not dismiss a complaint that there is no negligence. It was decided that too many doctors were involved, too much of treatment in Calcutta and in Mumbai, and so much evidence of so many doctors in different places. So that is why we actually dismiss the complaint. It is not appropriate place to handle so much work. It is not that we decided there is no negligence. It was not said so clearly. It was only because of the complicated case that it was, and in two different states. And he with his media behind him, you know, we just felt it was not an appropriate case. I just want to clarify that. But it is not that we actually said there's no negligence.
One-line comment on two important dimensions in the judgment when we study the judgment. One is the proportionality of negligence between the different actors, and second is even the quantum of compensation compared to the proportionality of liability. So that's those points also we cannot neglect, I think, when we analyze the judgment. And the expert evidence which was brought from abroad in this case, which is presented before the court.
How is it different or a loss that in a railway accident, when a thumb is lost, that thumb is compensated by 40,000, and when a thumb is cut by the nurse in during medical treatment, an amputation because IV fluid extravasation is costing 20 lakhs. It is difficult for me as a layperson to accept this.
Srimati Rajalakshmi, I have a question for you. We have seen that we can be tried in different fora. Would you have any relief for us? Is there anything that we can do as a body to...
Once the civil suit is filed, consumer fora will not entertain the complaint. When consumer complaint is filed, civil suit normally is not entertained.
What about the other, the criminal?
Criminal case is altogether different. There, neither civil court can say anything, nor consumer court can say anything, nor even the government can say anything. It's a negligence, gross negligence amounting to 304A.
I'd also like to comment. What we are talking here is when we say regarding multiple fora, I went in complaint against Times of India to Press Trust of India. And the first thing they asked me, the Times of India had published 45, yesterday I was telling you about the same, 45 front page news items on a particular case. The Press Trust of India, first thing they asked me was, given affidavit, that you have not filed this case in any other court of law. When you go to State Medical Council against me, after you have gone to consumer court, you have filed a criminal case, you have gone to National Human Rights Commission, the State Commission welcomes the case. So my only point is, in how many fora? Because the doctor's punishment starts the moment a case is filed against him, not when the judgment is delivered.
A small clarification, sir, I would like to have on behalf of all the audience. Is it possible to have capping of compensation as has been implemented in certain states in USA right from 1986? The moment the capping has come to $30,000, $3 million, etc., the number of cases dropped down by 71%. And that's what the clear statistics show. And more states in the United States are going for capping of compensation. So if this is...